In this problem, we want to calculate the fugacity of saturated steam at 250 degrees C using data from the steam tables. So the idea would be the steam tables have enthalpy and entropy values. So the plan would be we could calculate Gibbs free energy at saturated steam conditions. And then we can take advantage of the relation between fugacity and Gibbs free energy. Essentially, we have to have a reference point where we know the fugacity, which would be at the same temperature but a low pressure. So the idea would be go to steam tables, look up values, and so at 250 degrees C, the saturation pressure for steam is 3.97 megapascals. And then we can look up the values for enthalpy and entropy. So these are the values from the steam tables for enthalpy and entropy for the vapor phase. And this means we can use the definition for Gibbs free energy, H minus TS, 2800. Minus the temperature, which is 250 plus 273.2 to make it absolute temperature, times 6.07. So this gives us a Gibbs free energy of minus 376. And this is joules per gram. Now we're going to convert, because we have to work in moles for the equations that relate Gibbs free energy to fugacity, 18 grams per mole, and so the Gibbs free energy is joules now per mole. The equation then that relates Gibbs free energy, and so it says if we have the Gibbs free energy of a component I, let's say at condition 2, minus the Gibbs free energy component I at condition 1, divided by RT, this is just related to the fugacity, and this is how we originally defined fugacity. So I'm going to call, so this is for a single component, that's why the I is there, and I'm going to call this condition 2. So we have this value. This is what we're trying to solve for, so we need another condition where we know the fugacity, which means at low pressure, fugacity of component that we're interested in this case, steam, is equal to the pressure. And we can go to the steam tables, 250 degrees C. The lowest pressure is 0.1 megapascals. And for steam at those conditions, we can look up the value for H and S. So these are the values in the steam tables. I'm going to call this condition 1, and so for steam at condition 1, I can calculate its Gibbs free energy from our definition of Gibbs free energy, 2977 minus 250 plus 273.2 and multiplied by 9.10. So the Gibbs free energy at condition 1 is minus 1784 joules per gram. Again, 18 grams per mole to put it in the appropriate units for the equation. And the value is minus 32,112 joules per mole. So the equation that we wrote up here, we're now going to use to make the substitutions. Gibbs free energy 2 is minus 6,767, and then Gibbs free energy 1 minus 32,112. These are both joules per mole. Gas constant 8.314 joules per mole per Kelvin. Temperature 273.2 plus 250 Kelvin. This is the log fugacity component steam, condition 2, of fugacity condition 1. But the fugacity at condition 1 is 0.1 megapascals, because this is the pressure. It's ideal gas at the low pressure where we calculate the fugacity, or give free energy. So at low enough pressure, it's ideal gas, fugacity, and pressure are the same. So the left side of the equation we can then calculate, and 5.8 is equal to this log of the fugacity ratios. So the fugacity at the condition we're interested in is 3.4 megapascals. So this is fugacity at a pressure of saturation pressure from the steam tables is 3.97. So at 250 degrees C, 3.97 megapascals, fugacity, this is a steam, is equal to 3.4 megapascals. So a reasonable check is fugacity is less than the pressure, which is typically what we expect. It's a similar value. So steam is non-ideal at 250 degrees C and 3.97 megapascals.